There's our new baby. I love it. I love seeing a homeowner work with industry experts to get their HVAC system installed and designed perfectly. I love it. So we're going to end up with two of these high-efficiency heat pumps.
Yep, 3 tons for upstairs and 3 tons for downstairs.
Right. And last week we met with your friend and energy expert, Jeremy Draper, and that helped determine the size of this equipment. It was some really interesting software you had.
What we do is we start with the architect's drawings of the as-built conditions, the way it's going to be after construction. And we take all the windows, doors, floors, and ceilings, and enter them into some software that helps us do all the math for us. Once we have all of the loads on the house, then it outputs some of the demands for the heating and cooling equipment. So with no insulation, single pane windows, for heating, you need about 6 tons and 5 tons of cooling.
What if we work on insulating?
Well, currently there's no insulation. We'll definitely be able to get the back side of the house and potentially the front side of the house.
Well, I hope so.
So if we insulate the back half of the house, it drops about 20% off of the system needs. So that's about 5 tons of heating and drops it down to about 4.5 tons of cooling.
Which means we could have 20% smaller equipment, right? We could have 20% lower operating cost. And that doesn't even count the escalation of fuel that's definitely gonna come. So it does make sense. You get your money back if you insulate, if you're gonna stay in that house.
Now we have to design the duct system. We needed to decide where we're gonna run the ductwork. And since it's an 1890s house with solid, real 2x8 framing and no chases between it or anything, then we needed to put it up in the attic. And the nice thing about the software is that there's an AutoCAD feature to it.
Oh, look at this, 3D. So now you can see the supply and the returns. We're gonna downfeed the top floor.
Then we add in the first floor, and we design all the ductwork locations, where the registers go, anything that we can get around, make sure that we're not trying to go through those slabs in the back of the house.
All right, so with what you've got here, we now know the size of the equipment, the air handlers and the condensers that we're gonna need. We now know the duct layout. We now know and can create a materials list, and we can get rolling.
That sounds good.
All right. Thank you for all your great help.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Jeremy.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project, so be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button to make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.